This is a Reforge reaction, and in this video, I'm going to be reacting to the Sonic Frontiers brand new combat video that went live on the PlayStation YouTube channel. If you like this Reforge reaction, be sure to check out my other reactions as well as Reforge Gaming. That's the channel where I stream live. Let's get right into this because I've been kind of harsh on this game, and I'm interested to see if the combat looks any better. So let's dive right in. I've not watched this yet. Sonic Team. Sonic Boom.
Sonic Frontiers introduces a new take on the action, adventure, and platforming genres by combining blistering speed with blazing combat.
It also has really weird open-world environments with drab plants. I'm just kidding. Sorry. I'm gonna be nice. I promise.
For the first time, Sonic has a skill tree full of exciting and powerful new abilities to learn.
Okay, so initial thoughts, if that's all there is, I want to see depth and impact, okay? That doesn't look very big. For the first time ever, Sonic has a skill tree that looks very small. I'm looking forward to this game. I'm not trying to be a hater. I think it could be really fun, but this doesn't look like a skill tree to me. This looks pretty small in the realm of skill trees. Lots of games have skill trees. This looks like one of maybe four or five.
To unlock new skills, you'll need to collect enough skill pieces from fallen enemies and breakable items around the islands. Sonic also has his standard moveset, including a homing attack, drop dash, and stomp at the beginning of the game.
Okay.
While these moves are effective against normal enemies, you'll need to level up and unlock new skills if you want to take on bigger and stronger foes awaiting you on the Starfall Islands.
Okay, so that right there, that looks awesome. Like, that is a boss fight. I'm kind of in. Like, that looks really, really good. I think one of the dilemmas with Sonic Frontiers gameplay up to now has been it's always like these really weird fights where they're small and you kind of do like almost like quick time event animations, like almost like prefab, predetermined things. It doesn't seem like the moment-to-moment action-adventure combat that you typically see in a third-person open-world game. I think it's going to be a challenge for Sonic Frontiers, but at the very least, I will say that a boss fight like this does look pretty dope. I do think some of the boss fights have been the more impressive things in the trailers, at least from my perspective.
A normal enemy on Chronos Island is nothing compared to those on later islands. So make sure you're collecting the red seeds of power and blue seeds of defense to boost your stats and give yourself a fighting chance.
Okay, I gotta chime in here. One of the things that we were concerned about when we saw that opening area with the plants and the mountains was it looked like they just sort of spit out prefab Sonic stuff on a generic, already pre-built world. And then we're in a desert biome, and I got kind of excited. Like, right back here, I was like, oh, cool, a new place. And then it advanced to here, and I'm seeing the same problems. I'm seeing, like, just random Sonic stuff strewn about. I'm seeing pop-in pieces that are just floating out here. You can see this. And I know people are going to be like, you're being nitpicky. You're freeze-framing. How else am I supposed to determine what the game's going to feel like without, like, just looking closely at a trailer instead of just letting the hype wash over me? So this is reminiscent of some of the problems we thought was in that opening area. Maybe it was an early build, maybe it was like a tech test, but here we are again with this sort of, I don't know, it doesn't look like a living, it doesn't look like the open world has purpose. It just looks like they've just sort of strewn stuff about on it. So let's keep watching.
Combos and abilities.
As the game progresses and Sonic levels up, so do your enemies. Completing combos is a good way to get the upper hand during battle, especially when paired with a new skill called Phantom Rush. Sonic's combo meter will fill up after attacking enemies consecutively. Once the combo meter is maxed out.
Okay, I want to go back and I want to highlight something without sound. So,
especially when paired with a new.
Wait, hang on. This right here, just going in and going wham, 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 I think that's fine if you like earn that every once in a while. I thought that was happening more rhythmically because some of the fights we saw early on, I felt like he was doing it a lot. This section here, where he's sort of moving around and periodically taking a hit, that actually looks really fun. Like right here, bam, bam, bam. Like that looks really fun, like almost like a challenge of you've got to time your hit so you don't get hurt. I think that looked really good. So I might be changing my mind a little bit about the combat, given that they could make it, I think, a little bit more interactive and not just, oh, you hit a button and Sonic does a big crazy combo. Like, I want to be the one engaging in the combos, if that makes sense.
Combo meter is maxed out, Phantom Rush is activated, and your attack power will be boosted until the meter reaches zero. To deal massive amounts of damage in a short burst, use Sonic Boom, a long-range, high-speed kick that unleashes shockwaves at the enemy.
Wait, so... Sonic Boom! I was kidding around, and it's also a kick? Street Fighter's gonna give you a call on the phone, I think. Is that... Are they allowed to do that? I don't know if they're allowed to do that.
Another option to dish out major hurt on your enemies is Wild Rush, a flashy, zigzagging attack that sends you crashing into your targets with great force. It's a fast and stylish way to hit your enemies hard while avoiding incoming fire.
Okay, no sound again. This is what I mean by sort of just prefab, everything's done for you. So Wild Rush, this is my concern. If I'm doing things like this too close together, it won't feel like moment-to-moment combat. It'll be like I'm just sort of pressing a button and then the game's doing everything for me. This right here doesn't... That doesn't look interactive or cool. It looks like a QuickTime event. You know what I mean? Some of this seems like a glorified QuickTime event, almost like you just earn the right to do combo A and then hit, earn the right to do combo B. Like, I don't know. I want to see uncut gameplay, because that's part of the problem with a lot of their trailers is I don't get uncut gameplay. And the uncut gameplay we did get in that one trailer was kind of boring. It was just kind of moseying around, walking around. Didn't feel like Sonic. So let's keep watching.
Incoming fire.
Siloop.
Certain enemies in Sonic Frontiers have a shield or barrier protecting them.
Okay, that right there looks good. Are you seeing the frame rate? I can't be the only person seeing the frame rate. It looks really smooth. I did see and watch. We reacted to Alana Pierce's video on this, and she said that the demo was so bad and buggy. This is looking like it's running well.
Break their shield with Siloop, and then deal as much damage as you can before it goes back up. If your opponent happens to land a hit on you, just use the Siloop ability on the ground to collect more rings and get back in the fight.
Wait, so you can just randomly do it to collect rings? I wondered earlier if he was doing something like he heard it or felt it. That's fine, I guess. That's fine. It just seems weird. Can you just randomly do that and get rings anywhere? I wonder if there's a maximum number you can hold or something.
Guardians.
During combat, you'll need to study your opponents and determine the best strategy to take them on. Encounters with Guardians will require more than just using your homing attack. Many of them prompt you to engage with their unique combat mechanics first before reaching their weak spot.
Okay, I dig that. I actually really, really dig that. Having mechanics in the boss fights that you have to sort of get through first before you can do damage and fight, I think that's actually pretty cool. I've not realized they were going to have that level of depth. That sounds good.
Once you have an opening, you can dish out all the skills you've unlocked from the skill tree. Experimenting with new abilities and discovering each enemy's weakness will help you defeat them with ease.
Okay, so you guys know what I'm going to say. Let me mute it and just rewatch it. So you earn the right to go do combat, right? So he does this ring thing. And he's so excited, right? It's time to go in there and fight. And prefab animation. It's prefab animation. It's just constantly dialing in a new, it does everything for you. I'm not saying that's a problem. I'm just kind of worried about how satisfying will that feel the 10th time you take down a boss, mini boss, or enemy that way. Will it feel like I'm doing it, or will it feel like, oh yay, I earned the right to do combo A, then combo B, and I'm not doing the combo. It seems like they're just sort of calling on it, and then it does everything for you because they want it to feel fast. I'm worried about what that's going to feel like as far as content loop goes.
Use your enemy's moves against them by utilizing parry during combat. A visual cue lets you know when an enemy is about to attack. If you react quickly enough, you can parry it and follow it up with a counterattack of your own.
People familiar with my content will tell you one of my favorite things to do in a game is parry. I love it. It's super satisfying. But I can't help but sound like a broken record when I say he parries this first guy, and then what's he do as a reward? Prefab animation. Another one. Like, yay, you parried, and then here... I don't know. Listen, I know folks are going to be like, you're just being a negative Nancy, but I love... One of my favorite types of games is third-person action-adventure games, and I am really, really worried that in this game, the big rewarding moments are all just prefab animations. Just, here's this... How many times are you going to see that combo before you get sick of seeing it? Like, yay, I got a parry, and now I'm spinning around really fast. Yay, I got a parry, and now I'm bam, 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 bam. How many times are you going to see that before you get sick of it? It's not going to feel interactive. It's not going to feel like you're the one doing it. I don't know. That's my speculation and concern here.
All these skills and more gives you tons of options to become the most formidable force in the frontier. Master your approach to battle and teach your enemies not to mess with Sonic the Hedgehog.
Well, listen... I obviously they're only promoting PS5, PS4 because it's on the PlayStation channel. I can't unsee that now. Like every time I look at the combat, that's all I see is it just sort of says, hey, we need animation set B, and then you just do it. We need animation set A, and then you do it. I just don't know. If the mechanics that lead up to those moments are satisfying, then it'll be really enjoyable. Like if parry feels really good to do, if satisfying boss mechanics just feels really good, and then that's sort of like your dialed in super sort of easy reward. I'll have to see what it feels like. I'll play it myself. Make sure you're subscribed to Reforge Gaming, where I stream live. As always, if you like this Reforge reaction, check out my other reactions. Hit subscribe and the bell button on this channel, and I'll see you in the next Reforge reaction.